Hello, Gary Hernandez here, and welcome to Cane Self-Defense with Master Gary Hernandez. Today I'm going to talk about manipulating somebody's head to get them off you using your cane. Now the part we're going to use on the cane is going to be your crook area. Now I'm going to be using the Cane Master's personal self-defense cane because it has the palm rest, which actually becomes almost like an English gentleman style cane. Now, you can do the same thing, and I'm going to show you how to do it also with a traditional round horn. Now, one of the things about when you're trying to get somebody off you, without really causing a lot of injury, you just kind of want to push them away. Now, if you try to push somebody in the body, that's a lot of mass. If they're a pretty big person, you're going to have a hard time pushing them off you. You know, there's an old saying, and I believe in this old saying, where the head goes, the body follows. So we're going to do that. Now from here, what I can do with my hands if someone's trying to reach out and grab me is I can push their face. I can use my palm. I can use my forearm. You know, I can just simply, I'm not talking about striking or hitting them in the throat or striking. I'm talking just getting them off you. It could be somebody who's drunk, just, you know, a little irritated coming on you and you want to push them off. So we're going to use the cane. Now, start off with this one, and then I'm gonna go to a more regular horn. Now on this crook here, like I said, because it has the palm rest, this works pretty well. And what I wanna do is, yes, I could simply catch them under the throat and push off, but I'm, you know, that's more of an area I could cause some injury if I happen to, they're coming in. You know, again, this is just getting somebody off you, not really trying to cause a lot of injury to them. So, I can easily put that there and push off and push them back. But I'm going to put it under the jawline, right there. Now, if you notice, when I do this, and I'll do it on the jawline, I'll do it on both sides here. I push off. You notice that I step back. I push them off me, yet I'm stepping back. Same thing if I'm on this side. I push and I step back. I could step and push at the same time and get more of a greater shove. But the thing is, I'm trying to get myself away from them without causing too much of an injury. Now, don't get me wrong, I can, because I push them back. Now, I could strike if I chose. Same thing, you know, push them back or further away, I can strike. You know, same with the thing, push them back in the throat, I can strike. So, I can do that. But that's basically, I'm just trying to get them off me. Now, doing it with a traditional horn, same exact thing. They're coming in, I simply pushing that jawline, pushing that jawline. Again, I could go into the throat and push back. The only thing about the traditional crook is if they're sweaty or if it's kind of raining, I could, if I'm moving really fast and I don't get a good bite on them, I could slip off. That's the only downfall. More the curvature style canes will fit perfectly in the jawline area or the throat. So practice, if you have both, practice with both, because you don't know what you're going to be carrying that day. If you only have this style, practice with this. If you only have this style, practice with this. And again, it's a basic, simple technique. On, you know, on this channel and these videos, I'm going to be showing you more advanced stuff. I'm going to be showing you basic stuff. I'm going to be showing you all kinds of different things because not everybody is expert level with a cane and not everybody is a beginner level. And there's in between. So again, I'm here. Stay away from me. They come in, catch that jawline, and I push them back. Look, stay away from me. They come in, catch that jawline, push them back. Again, I could go for the throat, but it's a little bit more delicate area. And if you got, you know, drunk Uncle Bob, you don't want to make him gag in his own saliva there, but still, maybe you do. I don't know. You know how family is. So again, simply catch that jawline. Again, notice I push and step back, creating distance, because now I can strike or I can come in if I had to pick it up a notch. So work those techniques gently with your partner, put it up in that jaw area, push them back. Trust me, where the head goes, the body follows. So I hope that helps. Another cane tip, and I will see you guys next week. Thank you.